number one in accounting, always ensure to have a grasp on your company's financial performance. What this means is to understand the following. Where is your money coming from and going to? That transactions are properly documented, and that internal financial ledgers and statements are in line with the external financial statements. This process is called account reconciliation and is a crucial part of every company's accounting process. In this video, we will focus on one specific type of account reconciliation, which is bank reconciliation. Bank reconciliation is one of the most popular types of account reconciliation and focuses on the company's transactions recorded internally versus what was recorded externally by the bank. So it compares the company's records in the ledger with the bank statements provided by the bank, and as a result, can help detect any discrepancies in the financial records. The overall goal of bank reconciliation is to make sure that the closing balances of both records are equal. How often a company reconciles the books highly depends on the company itself. Most companies do their bank reconciliation once a month, but bigger companies might reconcile their books on a weekly or even daily basis, whereas smaller companies might just do it at the end of each quarter or once every 6 months. In an example in this video, we are comparing the bank statement for the month of June with our cash book entries of the same period. To perform bank reconciliation, you need to follow along a couple of steps. First, collect all your data, read it into KNIME Analytics Platform, and bring it into a comparable format to ensure the structure is as expected. From here, get a first assessment of the situation by comparing the closing balance of both records and by highlighting matching and mismatching entries of both the bank statement and the cash book. We can get two pieces of information from here. The unreconciled amount, this is the difference between the closing balances of the two records, and details about which transactions are matching and which are not. By comparing the entries, we can account for three types of mismatches. Omissions. These are activities on the bank account that are not yet included in the cash book. This comes from transactions of which the company does not know about until they appear in a bank statement, for example, bank fees or in the case of missing receipts. Timing differences. Sometimes transactions are recorded in different time periods in the cash book and in the bank statement. For example, when a payment has already been recorded in a cash book but has not yet been processed by the bank. Such timing differences usually adjust themselves in the future. Errors by the accountant or the bank. Those are erroneous transactions, for example, the recording of an incorrect transaction amount. So from here, we continue with only the mismatching transactions and adjust the bank statement balance and the cash book balance accordingly. To the bank statement, we add deposits in transit or deduct outstanding checks. And we account the cash book for any type of omissions. For example, by adding interest received or deducting bounced checks. And finally, we check for errors. By adjusting those balances, we reduce our unreconciled amount. The bank reconciliation was successful once the adjusted closing balance of the bank statement equals the adjusted closing balance of the cash book. This amount corresponds to our true cash balance. You can now take it from here and prepare the journal entries to accommodate for the adjustments made, so that next time you do a bank reconciliation, you don't face the same issues again.